Guys, so
listen to Abuna.
Yeah, history of the island.
This island. About 60 years ago, or 70 years ago, after the Second World War, my ancestors bought this island. They bought this island. So we are not Fijian. We are Tuvaluans. Tuvaluans is Polynesian. Here in the South Pacific, we have three kind of people. Polynesian, Melanesian, and Micronesian. Right. In New Zealand, they have the Maorians, they are Polynesian. So we have similar language. We can understand each other. Samoa, Tonga, Polynesian. So the Tuvaluan is one of the Polynesian islands. So after the war, our people that went to the war collect money and they decided to buy an island. That time, the Fiji and the South Pacific Island were under the British colony. So, people from our island, from Tuvalu, have good relationship with these English people, and they decided that why buy this island from Fiji. So, they move or they migrate from Tuvalu and settle in this island. So, we bought this island for only about 5,000 grand. Fijian.
Wow.
The currency at that time. Actually, it was on auction sale. On auction, they put on auction. And business people in Fiji, they want to buy the island. But because they know it's a colony, it's under the British government, they decide, oh, we cannot compete with this. So it ends there, so our people were fortunate that they were able to collect that money and bought this island. Actually, they do believe that this island that God gave them. Actually, in Tuvalu, it's an atoll, all flat. No mountain, no. So now we live here for about 70 years now. And my father migrated from Tuvalu.
So your father from
we are the third generation.
You see your father from the very early people.
Very early people
who came here.
So now, because we live in Fiji, and we are called ourselves Fijian. We were born here.
So,
in an island for sale now.
And we pray that. Sayeda is the second bishop to visit here. And people in the island said, why are you bringing a bishop here to the island? I said, if God's willing, maybe we're going to turn to Coptic. And we pray.
Coptic Island.
So we have a church here?
We have a church. It's a Protestant church, Methodist church.
Methodist.
In Tuvalu language. So today we're going to perform a traditional Tuvaluan dance. We have Fijian culture, now we have we still keep our Tuvaluan tradition, even the language.
That's why you said this is not part of Fiji, because it has different ancestors, right?
Yeah, it's not part, still part of Fiji, but it belongs
political
to
part of Fiji, but
the
history,
the people,
historical?
The history, no, we are,
you are not Fijians.
Just like our Coptic people move away, so they're still practicing the Coptic way of life.
So everybody here is Tuvalu?
Yes. Right. Some they married to Fijians.
It's okay.
But the majority are still Tuvalu. And we still want to keep our culture.
So you have schools here?
It's only primary school. Preschool and primary school. High school, we send it to Tarini or Suba.
Hospital? You have hospital here?
Just a nursing station. A nurse serve here. Small clinic.
Small clinic.
We go to a hospital in Tarini.
And what does it mean? What people do here? Farming and
fishing? Mostly like fishing.
Fishing.
Farming.
And do you have any cars here?
No,
no
cars. Road here. They didn't want to build road. They travel by, you can see a lot of Africa canoes and boats. So they travel around.
But by the boats?
Boat, yeah. They prefer to leave the island as it is.
But animals like donkeys, you can
horses, you can cross.
Horses, okay. I wish I can live on an island like this.
It's very quiet. Even the way out, it's only one village here. And the island is even subdivided with the first people that came here.
Yeah.
So we have our own land.
So you divided the island between the
first people
who came here. Okay.
So they have a house there, they do the farming.
Farming, yeah.
But they come to the village for function, school. It's not
fun. Like your dad and yourself. You were doing fishing and farming, that's it?
Yes.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, Abunandu is a fisherman. He became now a fisherman.
Fisherman. Yeah.
Even these Africa canoes.
Yeah.
People go in the morning, fish, sell the fish in Tayuni, and come back to them. Fish for home.
Do they
every day?
How do they get to Tavioni?
They use the sail. Oh. They put the sail. They go travel with the wind and the current.
Sailboat.
So how long it takes? Sailboat. They go and come back again.
How long it takes?
2 hours at least.
Well, they'll go they fish on the way to Tavioni.
How long?
With sailboat, how long they go, man? How many minutes?
How many
hours?
If it's strong wind, strong wind, they put a sail. It's faster than the boat we come.
Oh, really? Strong wind. But regular wind like today.
Like today, maybe an hour.
Hour?
Wow.
But usually they don't travel fast, but they fish. Mm. When they catch enough, they put a sail.
Come back.
What are the main fruits and vegetables here? That you can plant and grow?
Mostly they plant it for their own use. All the fruit you can see the market grow here. The root crop.
Is there electricity?
Any
electricity?
You
have electricity?
We have a generator.
Generates, but not electricity, not regular.
No.
Generators.
Now I think the government wants to put solar.
Yeah, solar cell phone.
And there is government here. How's government here?
We have our own village, admin.
So if there is a conflict between like two families or whatever, they go to the head of the village?
Yes, everything is dealt here.
Dealt internally?
We don't have police. And unless in very serious case, then you take it to the mainland, police case. Otherwise, everything is settled.
And no police here?
No.
Crime?
You can hear that?
What do you
hear? That sound everybody near, then you come to the home.
Oh, that's like the bell. So now he's calling everybody to come here.
This is a shell. This is a shell.
It's a conch shell, right?
Shell, yeah.
So officially, this is not part.
You see, this is my uncle. This is an MC.
This is your uncle?
Okay. Okay. We even, maybe after the. Actually, our traditional welcome is different from the Fijian. Fijian, they use the welcome.
Mm.
Our traditional custom, we have a traditional dance.
Dance?
So they make the dance, and all the speech. And at the end of the speech, you can have a traditional custom. They love it. Then the ladies, they come and spread the handicraft. Can buy souvenirs.
When the hurricanes or cyclone comes, how frequent, how much destruction, and
very strong wind.
Very
But usually we have hurricane season come from the end of the year, from November to April. But not all the time.
Not all the time.
Is there like a safe house that you go towards more the middle of the
island? Yeah, this is the community wall. Everybody gets there.
But this is very close to the sea.
We don't have tidal waves or.
Just wait.
Yeah. It's Eddie. Edwin's my uncle.
Yeah,
hi, nice to meet you.
Hello, Mr. MC.
Hey, you just take a seat, take a seat. No worries, no worries. It's Eddie.
Well, that's
Eddie, nice to meet you. Eddie, nice to meet you.
So you can ask a question about Alan, he can.
Yeah.
Nina,
we're happy to visit your island here.
Yeah, thank you.
Can you tell us more about the island? I want to just give us small history about the island, but you can tell us more about your tradition, your custom.
Telling them about buying this island 50 years ago, but he knows me better.
Yeah, okay.
The up and down on the island, the development. Bishop, Yusuf.
Hello. How are you? Nice to meet you. So what are you going to tell us about this?
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I think I'll try and brief just a short history. I know that you all understand English, you know better than me. Anyway, I will try and brief a short history about the island of Kiowa and also the people, and probably you might want to know where they come from. We are Polynesians and we came from a different country. To purchase this island, it was done in the year 1947. The first wave left their home of birth back in Tuvalu. That's our country. That's where our forefathers came from. Tuvalu is made out of eight islands. That's where our forefathers came from. And the biggest island back in Tuvalu is only 4 square miles big. That's the biggest island. And they're all flat. They don't have any mountains. They don't have any hills. And that's the island that where our parents came from. Kiowa is 8 square miles, so it's double the size. Back in the year 1946, the elders back in homeland, they came down to Fiji to find an island. They want to buy an island away from Tuvalu. The reason of buying an island away from Tuvalu, right now it's happening. Climate change, rising of the sea level, and also the increasing of the population. Because like what I've said a bit earlier, the biggest island there is only 4 square miles. That back in the year 1946. So anyway, in 1947, 26th of October, the first wave landed their feet on the island. Yeah, that was the first wave. 37 volunteers who left the home of birth. And
how many volunteers?
37 volunteers.
87.
37. Yeah, they left the home of birth and came down to start off a new home. Without knowing the people here in Fiji, they are so new to the island. They don't even know the cultures of the people of Fiji.
Yeah.
And anyway,
was there anybody in this island?
The place was naked. Nobody was on the island.
Nobody.
To say hello, to say talofa, to say mbula in Fijian.
Nobody.
Yeah, the place was just empty. They said it was just wild birds, wild animals, greeting them.
So, wild animals.
Yes.
Like what? What kind?
Like of wild dogs, wild pigs, which they don't have them back in Tuvalu. Mm. Anyway. They bought this island for £3,000, which I believe that you can't even buy in a piece of land with such a small money. So our parents were blessed, and then this is their home, this is their paradise. It was given to them. And they believe it's a land given to them by God.
Yes, it is.
So it's only £3,000. So back in the year 1947, 37 volunteers came down to the year 1962, the population came up to 200 people on the island. And from 1947 to 1962, there was 10 waves came all together, meaning 10 waves, 10 different groups came in different months, in different years, so...
But all of them from the original?
Yeah, from the same island.
Tuvalu.
Same island. They are the people that bought this island. Out of the 8 islands in Tuvalu, they bought the island themselves. So 110 shareholders which bought the island. 110. So we are the generation of our forefathers. Our parents have passed away. They were given us a home for us to live on. So right now the population of Kiowa, I will roughly tell you that the population of Kiowa is 1,100, which is probably only 1/3 is on the island, 2/3 is gone abroad. Most of them at education and also at work, where Abuna came from. So most of them in the mainland. So right now, the population, the people living on the island is probably 300 plus, could be 400. And most of them, they all over the world.
And all of you are related to each other?
Yes.
And you know each other?
We know each other. This is the only main village we have, and we have only one village. And the island is surrounded by settlements, very small settlements, which is given to individual families. He has his own settlement, I have my own settlement, that's where I do my planting, my farming, that's for my family. And we only have this main village.
And with the rest of the people, how do they live, other than the settlement?
Houses? We have houses on the island, the village is about 84 to 87 probably.
May I ask what's the difference between settlement and house?
Come again?
What's the difference between settlements and house?
Oh, settlements is like small blocks, piece of land given to you.
Mm.
I have my own house and a piece of land given to me by the 110 shareholders. Mm.
But house, just house, there is no land?
No, I've got my land, I've got my house, he's got his land, he's got his house. That's surrounding the island.
Okay.
Mostly he's talking about the total of house in the
houses.
Village.
87.
In the village.
So 80.
87. Yeah, something about 87. Yeah, so on the island we have councillors. We have two chiefs, two clans, which they look after our culture. And when our forefathers came down, they brought down with them so many cultures. And one of the famous culture, we're still holding on now, is our traditional dancing. And they came down with one religion, and that's the church building.
Yes.
Yeah. So that's some history about the people and also where they come from.
Thank you.
If you have any question, I will be able to.
Yeah, the right question.
So you were born here in the island?
Come again?
You were born in that island?
I was born on the island, and I'm a Fiji citizen.
Do you mix with the Fijians? Anybody from here got married from Fijians?
Intermarried?
Mommy?
Intermarried?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
I
think the next generation, the new generation start marrying
from outside.
Some of our young
people,
they go back to
I think you heard something about climate change.
Yeah.
The rising of the sea level. I went back to our homeland in the year 1991, came down, went back again in 1999, and this is where I saw the changing of the climate, I mean, the rising of the sea level, damaging a lot. Because like what I've said, we don't have any mountains, we don't have any hills, like the highlands, so we only have just flat. And it's, I mean, the rising of the sea level is damaging a lot. So that's why I saw the changing of the climate. I went down again in the year 2016. And that's why I saw a lot of damage. And people, they still believe that the island is given to them by the living God, and they see will die on this island.
Do you have a map here, like
Oh, okay. Right now we don't have any map. Any map.
Can you do it like
Kiowa is in Fiji, and it's about 700 to 800 miles up north of Fiji. That's where our forefathers came from. It's a different country. So in order to go up, to
north or south, like you go one north.
North of Fiji. Traveling by boat takes you 3 days traveling.
Okay, but north of Fiji.
Fiji. And then it's up north of Fiji. So it's a different country.
Yeah.
So coming down to Fiji, you have to apply for a visa or passport.
Okay.
And even us, if we live, if we want to go down to Tuvalu, we have to apply for a passport. We're going to another different country.
So even though you are ancestor from Tuvalu, but you need you need a visa to get into Tuvalu.
Just because I was born here in Fiji, and I'm a Fiji citizen.
So officially, this is under the control of Fiji?
Fiji, yes.
So even though it's a private island, but it's still officially part of Fiji.
Yeah, we are under Fiji government.
Under the Fiji.
Tuvalu under which government?
They own their own Tuvalu government.
They have their own government.
Their own government?
Yes.
Ah, okay.
They have their own government. And Tuvalu, like I said, is only 8 islands. And they have the 9th island, and that's back in here in Fiji, and that's Kiowa. Although we are Tuvaluans, and the island is still under Fiji government.
Can you describe us, you know, one day in the life of the people here? How they spend the time, what's their activities?
Okay.
Usually, a typical day, how it looks like?
Okay, on the island, life on the island here, it's just like, it's a simple life. Like, we live together, we work together, we do things together. And the source of income on the island is just ladies' handicrafts. You might see some of them. And also the men's fishing and their farming. The men here on the island are very good fishermen, and they can tell which type of fish they bite at a certain time. And I think that's the only source of income on the island. Mm-hmm. And then, like, doing things together, we work together.
Do you watch TV, cinema?
Come again?
Cinema, TV.
Yes, you have your own in your home. Mm.
Do you get tourists to come?
Tourists?
Yes.
Every day.
Oh yeah?
Yes.
Now another two groups coming
after
us.
Groups. After your group?
It's a day visit, right? They don't stay.
No, they come in anytime.
We don't encourage to build
hotel.
No hotels here.
No hotels.
Well, just around neighborhood, all hotels around.
We have so many resorts just very close by, so they come.
They come every day.
Yeah. And go back to the resort.
People do their entertaining, and that's where they get the administration. They get the money from.
Oh, okay.
The tourists come in. For us, like our group, they have to donate them.
Okay.
So, ladies and gentlemen, our program. I will show you the way to go into the building when the dancers are ready. The ladies will stand in front of the door from inside. They will place flowers like what I've got on my head. And then I'll show you where to sit, and then they will do the singing, and also the dancing. We'll do the watching.
Sounds great.
So after the dancing, the ladies so pleased to place the handicrafts. And you just can make a walk in the middle. Then see side to side. If you want to take something like powerful for a souvenir, but please don't take them all, leave some for us. I'm only kidding. You just can move around and see if you want to take something like powerful. Ladies
Thank.
Are so pleased, and they're looking forward.
Thank you.
That's so.
listen to Abuna.
Yeah, history, history of the island.
This island, about 60 years ago, or 70 years ago, after the Second World War, my ancestors bought this island. They bought this island. So we are not Fijian. We are Tuvaluans. Tuvaluans is Polynesian. Here in the South Pacific, we have three kinds of people. Polynesian, Melanesian, and Micronesian. Right. In New Zealand, they have the Maorians, they are Polynesian. So we have similar language. We can understand each other. Samoa, Tonga, Polynesian. So the Tuvaluan is one of the Polynesian islands. So after the war, our people that went to the war collect money and they decided to buy an island. That time the Fiji and the South Pacific Island were under the British colony. So people from our island, from Tuvalu, have a good relationship with these English people, and they decided to buy this island from Fiji. So they move or they migrate from Tuvalu and settle in this island. So we bought this island for only about 5,000 grand.
Fijian.
Fijian.
Wow.
The currency at that time. Actually, it was on auction sale. On auction, they put on auction. And business people in Fiji, they want to buy the island. But because they know it's a colony, it's under the British government, they decide, oh, we cannot compete with this. So it ends there. So our people were fortunate that they were able to collect that money and bought this island. Actually, they do believe that this island that God gave them. Actually, in Tuvalu, it's an atoll, all flat. No mountain, no hill. So now we live here for about 70 years now. And my father migrated from Tuvalu.
So your father from
we
the...
We are the third generation.
You see your father from the very early people,
very early people
who came here.
So now, because we live in Fiji, and we are called ourselves Fijian. We were born here.
So,
in the island for sale now?
And we pray that Sayeda is the second bishop to visit here. And people in the island said, why are you bringing a bishop here to the island? I said, God's willing, maybe we're going to turn to Coptic. And we pray.
Coptic Island.
So we have a church here?
We have a church, it's a Protestant church, Methodist church.
Methodist.
In Tuvalu language. So today we're going to perform a traditional Tuvaluan dance. We have Fijian culture, now we still keep our Tuvaluan tradition. Even the language.
That's why you said this is not part of Fiji, because it has different ancestors, right?
Yeah, it's not part, still part of Fiji. Was
political
Fiji.
Part of Fiji, but
the
historic,
the people,
historical?
The history, no, we
you are not Fijians.
Okay.
Just like our Coptic people move away, so they're still practicing the Coptic way of life.
So everybody here is Tuvalu?
Yes. Some they married to Fijians,
okay.
The majority are still. And we still want to keep our culture.
So you have schools here?
It's only primary school.
Primary school.
Preschool and primary school. High school, we send it to Tarini or Suba.
Hospital? You have hospital here?
Just a nursing station. A nurse service, yeah? Small clinic.
Small clinic.
We go to a hospital in Tarini.
And what is the main, what people do here? Farming and
fishing? Most life
fishing.
Farming.
And do you have any cars here?
Any?
Car?
No. No
cars.
Road here. They don't want to build road. They travel by, you can see a lot of Arctic canoes and boats. So they travel around.
But by the boats?
Boat, yeah. They prefer to leave the island as it is.
But animals like donkeys, you can...
Yeah, we have horses, you can cross.
Horses, okay. I wish I can live on an island like this.
It's very quiet. Even the way out, it's only one village
here. $5,000
And the island is even subdivided to the first people that came here.
Yeah.
So we have our own land.
So you divided the island between the
first people
who came here. Okay.
So they have a house there, they do the farming.
Farming, yeah.
But they come to the village for function, for school. It's not
so like your dad and yourself. You were doing fishing and farming, that's it?
Yes.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, Abunanto is a fisherman. So he became now a fisherman.
Fisherman. Yeah.
Even these Arctic canoes.
Yeah.
People go in the morning, fish, sell the fish in Tayuni, and come back to the fish for home.
Do they
every day.
How do they get to Tayuni?
They use the sail. All the put the sail. They go travel with the wind and the current.
Sailboat.
So how long it takes?
Sailboat. They go and come back again.
How long it takes?
2 hours at least.
Well, they go. They fish on the way to the Tayuni.
How long?
With sailboat. How long they go? How many minutes?
How many hours?
With the
if
sailboat.
It's strong wind, strong wind. They put the sail.
Mm.
It's faster than the boat we come.
Oh, really?
Oh, yes.
Mm. Strong wind. But regular wind like today?
Like today, maybe an hour.
Hour?
Wow.
But usually they don't travel fast because they fish. Mm. When they catch enough, they put a sail.
Come back.
What are the main fruits and vegetables here that you can plant?
Mostly they plant it for their own use. All the fruit you can see the market grow here. The root crop.
Is there electricity?
Any
electricity?
Yeah,
you have electricity?
We have a generator.
Generates, but not electricity, not regular.
No.
Generator.
Now I think the government wants to put the solar.
Yeah, solar cell.
And there is government here. How is government here?
We have our own village admin.
So if there is a conflict between like two families or whatever, they go to the head of the village?
Yes, everything is dealt here.
Dealt internally?
We don't have police. And unless in very serious case, then you take it to the mainland, police case. Otherwise, everything is settled.
And no police here?
Okay. No.
Crime?
You can hear that?
What do you
hear? That sound, everybody near, then come to the hall.
Oh, that's like the bell. So now he's calling everybody to come here.
This is a shell. This is a shell.
It's a conch shell, right?
So officially, this is not part.
Well, you see, that's my uncle. He's an MC.
This is your uncle.
Again.
Okay.
We even maybe after the actually our traditional welcome different from the Fijian. Fijian they use the wisdom.
Mm.
But traditional custom we have the traditional dance.
Dance.
Do they make the dance and all the speech. And at the end of the speech you can have a speech. They love it. They love it. Then the ladies they come and spread the handicraft. Buy souvenirs.
When hurricanes or cyclone comes, how frequent, how much destruction, and
very strong wind. But usually we have hurricane season come from the end of the year, from November to April. But not all the time.
Not all the time.
Yeah, this is the community hall. Everybody gets there. We don't have tidal waves or.
It just went.
Yeah. It's Eddie. Edwin's my uncle.
Yeah,
hi, nice to meet you.
Mr. MC.
You just take a seat, take a seat. No worries, no worries. It's Eddie.
Well, that's
Eddie, nice to meet you.
So you can ask
a
question about Alan, he can.
We're happy to visit your island here.
Yeah, thank you.
Can you tell us more about the island? I want to just give us small history about the island, but you can tell us more about your tradition, your custom.
Just telling them about buying this island 60 years ago, but he know better.
Yeah, okay.
The up and down of the island, the development. Bishop, Yusuf.
Hello. How are you? Nice to meet you. So what are you going to tell us about this?
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I think I'll try and brief just a short history. I know that you all understand English, you know better than me. Anyway, I will try and brief a short history about the island of Kiowa and also the people, and probably you might want to know where they come from. We are Polynesians and we came from a different country. To purchase this island, it was done in the year 1947. The first wave left their home of birth back in Tuvalu. That's our country. That's where our forefathers came from. Tuvalu is made out of eight islands. That's where our forefathers came from, and the biggest island back in Tuvalu is only 4 square miles big. That's the biggest island, and they're all flat. They don't have any mountains, they don't have any hills, and that's the island that where our parents came from. Kiowa is 8 square miles, so it's double the size. Back in the year 1946, the eldest back in homeland, they came down to Fiji to find an island. They want to buy an island away from Tuvalu. The reason of buying an island away from Tuvalu, right now it's happening. Climate change, rising of the sea level, and also the increasing of the population. Because like what I've said a bit earlier, the biggest island there is only 4 square miles. That back in the year 1946. So anyway, in 1947, 26th of October, the first wave landed their feet on the island. Yeah, that was the first wave. 37 volunteers who left the home of birth. And
how many volunteers?
37 volunteers.
87.
37. Yeah, they left the home of birth and came down to start off a new home. Without knowing the people here in Fiji, they are so new to the island. They don't even know the cultures of the people of Fiji.
Yeah.
And anyway,
was there anybody in this island?
The place was naked. Nobody was on the island.
Nobody.
To say hello, to say talofa, to say mbula in Fijian.
Nobody.
Yeah, the place was just empty. They said it was just wild birds, wild animals, greeting them.
So, wild animals.
Yes.
Like what? What kind
like
of?
Like wild dogs, wild pigs, which they don't have them back in Tuvalu. Mm. Anyway. They bought this island for £3,000, which I believe that you can't even buy in a piece of land with such a small money. So our parents were blessed, and then this is their home, this is their paradise. It was given to them. And they believe it's a land given to them by God.
Yes, it is.
So it's only £3,000. So back in the year 1947, 37 volunteers came down to the year 1962, the population came up to 200 people on the island. And from 1947 to 1962, there was 10 waves came all together, meaning 10 waves, 10 different groups came in different months, in different years, so...
But all of them from the original?
Yeah, from the same island.
Tuvalu.
Same island. They are the people that bought this island. Out of the 8 islands in Tuvalu, they bought the island themselves. So 110 shareholders which bought the island. 110. So we are the generation of our forefathers. Our parents have passed away. They were given us a home for us to live on. So right now the population of Kiowa, I will roughly tell you that the population of Kiowa is 1,100, which is probably only 1/3 is on the island, 2/3 has gone abroad. Most of them at education and also at work, where Abuna came from. So most of them in the mainland. So right now, the population, the people living on the island is probably 300 plus, could be 400. And most of them live all over the world.
And all of you are related to each other?
Yes.
And you know each other?
We know each other. This is the only main village we have, and we have only one village. And the island is surrounded by settlements, very small settlements, which is given to individual families. He has his own settlement, I have my own settlement, that's where I do my planting, my farming, that's for my family. And we only have this main village.
And with the rest of the people, how do they live, other than the
settlement? We have houses on the island, the village is about 84 to 87 probably.
May I ask what's the difference between settlement and house?
Come again?
What's the difference between settlements and house?
Settlements is like small blocks, piece of land given to you.
Mm.
I have my own house and a piece of land given to me by the 110 shareholders. Mm.
But house, just house, there is no land?
No, I've got my land, I've got my house, he's got his land, he's got his house. That's surrounding the island.
Okay.
Mostly he's talking about the total of house in the
houses.
Village.
87.
In the village.
So 80.
87. Yeah, something about 87. Yeah, so on the island we have councillors. We have two chiefs, two clans, which they look after our culture. And when our forefathers came down, they brought down with them so many cultures. And one of the famous culture, we're still holding on now, is our traditional dancing. And they came down with one religion, and that's the church building. Yes. Yeah. So that's some history about the people and also where they come from.
Thank you.
So if you have any question, I will be able to.
Yeah, the right question.
So you were born here in the island?
Come again?
You were born in that island?
I was born on the island, and I'm a Fiji citizen.
Okay, mix with the Fijians, like anybody from here got married from Fijians?
Intermarried?
Mommy?
Intermarried?
Yeah?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I think the next generation, the new generation start marrying
from outside.
Even some of our young people, they go back to...
I think you heard something about climate change,
yeah.
The rising of the sea level. I went back to our homeland in the year 1991, came down, went back again in 1999, and this is where I saw the changing of the climate, I mean, the rising of the sea level, damaging a lot. Because like what I've said, we don't have any mountains, we don't have any hills, like the highlands, we only have just flat. And the rising of the sea level is damaging a lot. So that's why I saw the changing of the climate. I went down again in the year 2016, and that's why I saw a lot of damage. And people, they still believe that the island is given to them by the living God, and they see will die on this island.
Do you have a map here, like
map and you can tell us where is your island and where is the original island where you came from.
Oh, okay. Right now we don't have any map. Any map.
Can you do it like
Kiowa is in Fiji, and it's about 700 to 800 miles up north of Fiji. That's where our forefathers came from. It's a different country. So in order to go up to
north or south, like you go one north. So
north of Fiji. Traveling by boat takes you 3 days traveling.
Okay, but north of Fiji.
Fiji. Fiji, and then it's up north of Fiji.
Okay.
So it's a different country.
Yeah.
So coming down to Fiji, you have to apply for a visa or passport.
Okay.
And even us, if we live, if we want to go down to Tuvalu, we have to apply for a passport.
Yeah.
We're going to another different country.
So even though you are ancestor from Tuvalu, but you need a visa to get into Tuvalu.
Just because I was born here in Fiji, and I'm a Fiji citizen.
So officially, this is under the control of Fiji?
Fiji, yes.
So even though it's a private island, but it's still part of Fiji.
Yeah, we are under Fiji government.
Under the Fiji.
Tuvalu under which government?
They only have Tuvalu government.
They have their own government.
Their own government?
Yes.
Ah, okay.
They have their own government. And Tuvalu, like over there, I said, it's only 8 islands. And they have the 9th island, and that's back in here in Fiji, and that's Kiowa. Also, we are Tuvaluans, and the island is still under Fiji government.
Can you describe us, you know, one day in the life of the people here? How they spend their time, what's their activities?
Okay.
Usually, a typical day, how it looks like?
Okay, on the island, right from the island here, it's just like it's a simple life. Like we live together, we work together, we do things together. And the source of income on the island is just ladies' handicrafts. You might see some of them. And also the men's fishing and their farming. The men here on the island are very good fishermen, and they can tell which type of fish they bite at a certain time. And I think that's the only source of income on the island. And then, like, doing things together, we work together.
Do you watch TV, cinema?
Come again?
Cinema, TV.
Yes, you have your own in your home.
Do you get tourists to come?
Tourists?
Yeah.
Yes.
Every day.
Oh yeah.
Yes.
Now another two groups coming.
Oh,
to us.
After your group.
It's a day visit, right? They don't stay.
They come in anytime, any day.
We don't encourage to build
hotel.
Hotel.
Oh, okay.
No hotels here.
No hotels.
Well, just around neighborhood. All hotels. Around.
We have so many resorts just very close by, so they come.
They come every day.
Yeah. And go back to the resort.
People do their entertaining, and that's where they get the administration. They get the money from.
Oh,
the tourists come in. For us, like our group, we have to donate them.
Okay.
So, ladies and gentlemen, our program. I will show you the way to go into the building when the dancers are ready. The ladies will stand in front of the door from inside. They will place flowers like what I've got on my head. And then I'll show you where to sit, and then they will do the singing, and also the dancing. We'll do the watching.
Sounds great.
So after the dancing, the ladies so pleased to place the handicrafts. And you just can make a walk in the middle. Then see side to side. You want to take something like a for a souvenir. But please don't take them all in somewhere. I'm only kidding. You just can move around and see if you want to take something back home. Ladies
Thank.
Are so pleased, and they're looking forward.
Thank you.
Thank you. America or USA. At Urugu, I'm in Australia. At the I took no get the Malo at the Bishop. And I think my name is in a Batina Yoms in Apatom to the Matato. We met Tandatos are you go, my what you go. Only allow you met only my fire. We press the Lima of my last week. We all Talufa. I'm very happy to come to this island and to meet all of you. This is my first visit to your island here. But I heard a lot about it, and everybody told me, did you visit Cuba before? I said no. So they told me, when you go, you will enjoy it. It's one of the very, very beautiful islands with beautiful people. So when I came here and I arrived, I asked about the history of the island. And I learned about the history of the island. And I am actually very impressed that your ancestors and your parents were very, very wise in order actually to choose an island away from the crowd, away from the busyness of this world, in order to enjoy calm, quiet, peaceful life with no distraction. And actually, here actually all of you, I can see you are one family, living in love, living in true spiritual bonding all of you together. So I am very, very impressed with your lifestyle. And actually, as I say, your ancestors were very wise back in 1947. They thought about purchasing an island, living in it, preparing for the future generation away from this very, very crowded and very busy world. And I heard a question, why you are coming here? Why you are coming here? Actually, I can say you are coming here for two reasons. Reason, I'll start with reason number two and then with reason number one. Reason number two, because we heard how beautiful your island is and how beautiful the people are. So we came here actually to enjoy being among you, listening to you, watching your dance, watching, you know, the wisdom of your fathers and sisters who actually prepared this island for you and for generations to come. But what's actually reason number one? As Abuna Anthony said, I am the Bishop of Southern States of United States of America. And in the Gospel of St. Matthew, the Lord Jesus Christ, before his ascension, he said to the disciples, go and preach the gospel in the whole world. So Jesus did not come to a single nation, or to a single race, or to a single group of people. He came to the whole world. And in heaven, as we read in the book of Revelation, St. John in his vision, he saw actually people from every culture, from every race, from every tribe, from every tongue. So heaven is multicultural. Heaven has people from every culture. So understanding this concept, yes, there is one body, the body of Christ, but all of us, whether we are Egyptian or American or from Kiowa or from Fiji or from Australia or from Canada or from Africa, Asia, any part in the world, all of us, when we believe in Jesus Christ, then all of us will become one body, the body of Christ. Yes, we have different background, we have different tongues, we have different upbringing, but all of us, we are brothers and sisters. I'm sure you say in the Lord's Prayer, our Father who art in heaven. You know why we don't say my Father who art in heaven? Why you say our? We say our because all of us are brothers and sisters, regardless where are we coming from. For this reason, I decided that every year, in with my parishioners in our diocese, to go and visit our brethren in different areas of the world. And actually this year, I decided to come and visit this blessed island, to come and to tell you that regardless who are coming from the other side of the world, but we are one. And we love you, and I'm sure you love us. We pray for you, and also I'm sure you will pray for us, because all of us, we are one in Christ. But you may say, my brothers here and sisters, when they introduce themselves, they said we are from the Coptic Orthodox Church. So maybe some of you, for the first time here, Coptic, although you have Abuna Anthony, he's Coptic Orthodox priest. The word Coptic means Egyptian. So this church is started in Egypt. When we say Coptic Orthodox, doesn't mean this church is limited only to the Egyptian people. No, it doesn't mean this. But it means that this church is started in Egypt. That when we say Coptic, it started in Egypt. And who started this church? You know, in the New Testament, we have four Gospels. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Mark, the author of the second Gospel, is the one, actually, he went to Egypt back in year 46 AD, about 12 years after the ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ to heaven. St. Mark went to Egypt and preached the gospel of salvation to the Egyptians. And Egypt knew the Lord, and they accepted Christianity. So Egypt is actually one of the very old countries that accepted Christianity. Egypt has 2,000 years of Christianity, from year 46 until today, and until the second coming of Christ. So Egypt actually is one of the very old churches in the world. After Jerusalem, because Christianity started in Jerusalem, then Egypt. And you call Jerusalem what? You call Jerusalem Holy Land, right? Why you call Jerusalem Holy Land? Because our Lord Jesus Christ grew up there, and he lived there. But do you know that Jesus lived also for 3 years and 6 months in another country? I'm sure some of you, or maybe all of you, know this. You know, when Jesus was born, King Herod wanted to kill Jesus. So the angel, as you read in the Gospel of St. Matthew, the angel said to Joseph and to Mary, take baby Jesus and escape to Egypt. So Jesus and his mother Mary and Joseph the carpenter lived in Egypt for 3 years and 6 months. So if we call Jerusalem Holy Land, because Jerusalem is the place where Jesus Christ grew, also we call Egypt Holy Land, because the Lord Jesus Christ with his mother and Joseph the carpenter lived there for 3.5 years. No other land in the world, no other country in the world was visited by the Lord Jesus Christ other than Jerusalem, except Egypt. So Egypt actually has a history of 2,000 years of Christianity, and also this is the only country that was visited by the Holy Family beside Jerusalem. And we call ourselves Coptic, I explained, means Egyptian, Orthodox. What Orthodox means? Orthodox means straight. What does this word mean? This means the doctrine and the teaching that Jesus Christ gave to his disciples and apostles, and the apostle gave to us. When you hear word Orthodox, this means We did not change anything. We did not change anything. The foundation, we did not change it. Yes, we built on it, but we did not change. The doctrine and the teaching that the Lord gave to the disciples, it is the same. That's what the word Orthodox. Let me share with you a story, a real story. About 20 years ago, a group of pastors want to search how the apostles in the first century worshipped Christ. So they studied for 8 years, how they worshipped Christ. And after 8 years of studying, they came to some conclusions. So they start to compare the conclusion, the outcome of 8 years of study, with all the existing churches. And to their disappointment, they did not find any church kept the teaching the same, kept the rituals the same at all. And they were very disappointed. So somebody told them, have you ever heard about the Orthodox Church? And they said, Orthodox, what does it mean? So they told them the Orthodox Church is a Christian church, but they kept the faith unchanging for 2,000 years. So they decided to go and to explore the Orthodox Church. And actually, they found that what they find out after 8 years of studying is exactly like how the Orthodox Church worship and how the Orthodox Church believes. And all of them, with their churches, they actually joined the Orthodox Church. And the bishop who baptized them, he told them, welcome home. Now you are returning back to your home. That's why they published two books, and these books are available. You can read them. One book called Coming Home, because they described their journey back to the Orthodox Church as a journey toward their home. And another book, it's called Becoming Orthodox, Becoming Orthodox. So when you hear Coptic Orthodox, Coptic means Egyptian, because this church started in Egypt, but it doesn't mean it is exclusively for the Egyptian. It does not mean this. When we say we are Coptic, means our roots in Egypt, but it is inclusive. It is open for everybody, every country, every tongue, every tribe, every nation. And also when we say Orthodox, this means the faith and the worship are not changed over 2,000 years. Coptic Church actually contributed to the world many, many things. As you know, the Lord Jesus Christ said that you will weep and lament, but the world will rejoice. He said, your children, if you want to be my disciple, carry your cross and follow me. And the Coptic Church offered the highest numbers of martyrs in the whole world till today. Martyrs means people die because of their faith. They have no other crime. They have no other fault except they are Christians. They are Christians. Martyrdom started in the first century. St. Mark, the author of the Gospel of St. Mark, was dragged in the streets of Alexandria, Egypt, on the Resurrection Eve, Easter Eve, till he died. And he became the first martyr in Egypt. And until this year, actually, every year, many people are killed for their faith. I'm sure maybe some of you heard about 21 Egyptians were working in Libya, and the terrorists asked them to deny their faith, but they refused. So they took these 20 martyrs on the Mediterranean Sea and recorded a video, and they slaughtered them, and their blood actually made the Mediterranean Sea red. The water became red because of the blood of the martyrs. None of them was afraid. They were very courageous in receiving death for the name of Christ. As the Bible says, unless you become my, if you want to be my disciple, carry your cross and follow me. So our church takes pride that until today, the children of the Coptic Church prefer this rather than to live and to deny Christ. So we take pride that we are the church of the martyrs. We are the church of the martyrs. Also, monasticism, people who live in seclusion, away from the world, it has the same philosophy, like how you choose this beautiful island to be away from the distraction. But monks, they want to stay away from the distraction of the world in order to enjoy their life with Christ only, no distraction. So they this engage everything in their life in order to be united only with Christ. And the first monk in the whole world was Egyptian, Saint Anthony the Great. And Abuna Anthony is named after Saint Anthony the Great, the first monk in the whole world. The faith and the doctrine, the creed that all of us we recite, we believe in one God, God the Father, the Almighty Creator of heaven and earth. Who is the author of this creed? Is Egyptian, Saint Athanasius, who wrote this creed in the Council of Nicaea. And all the churches until now, they recite. So the Coptic Church contributes to the world teaching martyrdom, monasticism, ascetic life, spirituality. That's why we are grateful to the Lord that He sent Saint Mark to Egypt in order actually to enlighten us about the Holy Trinity and to teach us how to worship God in spirit and in truth. So we are here to tell you that we are your brethren. Yes, we are different background. We are from Egypt originally. Yes, now we live in America, Australia, Canada, other part of the world. But we came here to tell you that all of us, we have the same God as our Father. All of us, we say our Father who art in heaven. And we want to introduce ourselves to you. Maybe some of you never heard about Coptic Orthodox Church. So now we are telling you, we are here because we love you. And as the Lord said, go to the whole world. So we are coming to tell you Jesus loves you, to introduce our Coptic Orthodox Church, this church that has its roots in Egypt, and in this church that never changed the worship or the doctrine, and until now this church bear witness to the Lord Jesus Christ. We are very happy to come here and to be with you today. We enjoyed your dancing, we enjoyed your singing. You have the beautiful voices I ever heard. I'm joking with my people here and tell them, once I go back to America, I will cancel all the choirs in our churches. After I heard your chanting, no more choirs in our church. Because you are blessed with beautiful chanting and beautiful voices. God bless you all. We pray for you. We ask you to pray for us. And God willing, we will come and see you again. And hopefully that you can come and visit us. And God be with you all.
On behalf of the people of Kiowa, I'd like to say thank you very much for a lovely speech, enlightening to our people. And we do also pray that God will be with your group, be with you as you travel back to the States. Now we allow the other group to come in. We just can on the side and take photos.
No, no, no. You can take it. You can take it.
No, who you are? I pick both.
Daddy, the woman.
Come on.